Hey Tuesday CT watchers, this is Kristin from Magoosh and quick pop quiz. How long is this pencil? Is it 7 centimeters, 7 inches, 7 feet, or 7 yards? Now, as long as you know what these units mean anyway, you could probably guess that the answer would be B, 7 inches, just using a little common sense, right? So why does this common sense just go completely out the window when you're taking the ACT? Well, I will tell you why. Because you're nervous, because you're getting caught up in all those calculations, and you forget to check the question after you get an answer and make sure that your answer makes sense. Let's look at a more test-like example. An $80 dress is on sale for 20% off. What is the sale price of the dress? Is it $16? Is it $60? Is it $64? 74 or 96. So if you got an answer of $16 after you do all that math and you circle A, well, that would be a really good sale. An $80 dress for $16 sounds like a lot more than 20% off to me. Or if you got an answer that is more than what the dress costs, if you got 96 for an $80 dress on sale, it's a pretty bad deal, right? But so many times you get caught up, you set up your proportion, you multiply something wrong, and you get one of those answers and you just circle it. So on the ACT, this is my first big tip for you. Think realistically on the math section. Most of the word problems are based on real world situations, and that means that the answer you're going to get is going to be realistic. They're not going to tell you that the mass of Jupiter, for example, is 6 grams. So make sure that you always go back and check the question after you get an answer and make sure that what you picked makes sense. This can also help you make some eliminations, even if you don't know how to solve the problem. Eliminate those answers that are too extreme to be an answer. And this also works really well on the geometry problems. Now, on the SAT, you'll see a lot of figures that are not drawn to scale, and it will tell you that. On the ACT, I've never seen an example of a question that says it's not drawn to scale. Maybe it's happened once in the history of the ACT, I don't know. But most of the time, the questions, the figures are roughly to scale, and that means you can assume that they are to scale. And so if you see an angle and you know it looks like it's more than 90 degrees, don't pick an answer choice that's less than 90 degrees. So think realistically and consider the diagrams you see to be realistic as well. Tip number two to improve your math score is to use the answer choices. On a standardized test like the ACT, you have this amazing gift sitting right in front of you, and it is the answer choice. You don't even have to really do calculations to find it. It's sitting right there. You just have to pick it out of 5 answer choices, which is, you know, still a task, but it's a much easier task than having a blank to fill. So use your answer choices. On a lot of problems, you can plug in answer choices into the question to solve the problem without really knowing how to solve the problem. So practice using that strategy as well. Plug in your answer choices. And tip number three is to move quickly through the questions. Now, on the ACT math sections, the questions aren't exactly arranged easy to hard. Now, generally, they do tend to increase maybe complexity or difficulty in terms of math concept, but there's not this stark difference between the beginning and the end of the test. So that means if you just studied identities in your trig class, for example, question 59 might actually be easier for you than question 12. And that means you don't want to get caught up just spending 3 minutes on an early problem and run out of time to see problems that you could have done and gotten right and get another question earlier on that you struggled with. So in the ideal world, you're actually going to be able to see, at least see all the questions that are on the test and make sure that you get all the questions that you can actually answer. So move quickly. If you can't do a problem right away, move on. You can always come back to it. Okay, so think realistically, use your answer choices, and move quickly, and you're going to be ready to improve your ACT math score. I know it. See you next Tuesday, ACT.